today, Abbey Road, room 5. We're recutting Tears for Fears album, The Hurting, from some half-inch tape, which is old-school analogue, using this old Ampex ATR machine. With old re-releases, it's better to go back to the source tapes if you can. This is one of the original production masters from 1983, so it's close to the original master, very close in fact, one analog generation away from the original master tapes. So it's as close as we can get the original tapes to the original record. Rather than use digitally archived WAV files, we're actually using the analog sources, if you like. Set up now, let's just rewind the tape machine back to the top and off we go. Blank lacquer disc, stainless steel disc with an 8th hour lacquer coating on it, the space around the edge. Pops on the turntable here. The suction sound you're going to hear is holding the disc flat on the turntable and taking away any residue, any chip that comes out when the record's cut. At the moment, I'm just going to do a test cut, make sure the lacquer's flat on the turntable, blemish free, and also flat across the surface. Right, small test cut, silent grooves, that all looks nice. Now they have a wee look in the microphone, just the microphone, the microscope. See they're not touching or any stylus aberrations. You can also see some grooves on the TV there. About a hair on your head, 50 microns. This is a Neumann VMS 80 cutting lathe, the same company that make the microphones. A good case in point here is this album is from 1983. This cutting lathe was built and designed in 1980. So you're actually using the same equipment that would have cut this record for the original release. I've been a mastery engineer now for 35 years, worked here for the last 8, doing CD prep and vinyl today. Today I've cut a record, Tears for Fears, The Hurting, from some Tape 1 analog half-inch production masters. And funnily enough, Tape 1 Studios was where I was trained. So I would have been around this studio where these tapes have come from in February 1983, 31 years ago. During my time at Tape 1 Studios, where I worked from 1979 to 1987, I was involved in quite a lot of really, really good groundbreaking vinyl records. I once spent a weekend cutting 15 sets of Brothers in Arms by Dire Straits, which is probably one of the biggest selling vinyl records of all time. And the other claim to fame, if you like, is I cut the original 2 sets of lacquers for New Order's Blue Monday, which I believe is the biggest selling 12-inch of all time.